which is actually by Marge Piercy, and it's my all-time most favorite organizing poem. Alone you can fight, you can refuse, you can take what revenge you can, but they roll over you. But two people fighting back to back can cut through a mob, a snake dancing file can break a cordon, an army can meet an army. Two people can keep each other sane, can give support, conviction, love, massage, hope, sex. Three people are a delegation, a committee, a wedge. With four, you can play bridge and start an organization. With six, you can rent a whole house, eat pie for dinner with no seconds, and hold a fundraising party. A dozen make a demonstration, 100 fill a hall, 1,000 have solidarity and your own newsletter, 10,000 power in your own paper, 100,000 your own media, 10 million your own country. It goes on one at a time. It starts when you care to act. It starts when you do it again after they said no. And we and I know, and we know what we mean when we say we, and each day you mean one more. So, Adora, you are a multitude. And I just want to remind people here who I think perhaps, I hope, have already read about Adora, but just in case, she is already a prolific short story writer and blogger since the age of 7. She's now 14. She speaks around the United States to adults and children as an advocate for literacy. She's a voracious reader and has been from age 3. Her first serious foray into writing at age 5 was limited only by her handwriting and spelling. Her astonishing verbal abilities already matched that of young adults over twice her age. As her official bio says, her breakthrough came in the form of a used Dell laptop her mother bought her. At age 7, she typed out over 250,000 words. I'm so late on a book, Adora, I really want to know. Poetry, short stories, observations about the world in a single year. She has since fashioned her beyond her years wordsmithing into an inspiring campaign for literacy. Speaking across the country to both adults and kids, she is author of Flying Fingers, a book on learning. Adora, we're so proud of you. You are our future.
Thank you. Well, I'd like to first thank the Women's Media Center for the tremendous opportunity.